Welcome to TCTAP 2022, the lab case. Today, we will perform a complex PCI case in the Asan Medical Center. I am Dr. Do Yoon Kang, an operator, and I will introduce my team. Dr. Jin-sun Park, our senior fellow of interventional cardiology, and Sun-deok Jang, our senior technician. And our skilled nurse, Ho Jung-gang, will help our procedure. And Dr. Jin-sun Park, can you please introduce our case?
Yes, I'm Jin-sun Park from Asan Medical Center. This is a complex PCI case. 62-year-old male patient was admitted for upper chest pain, and his coronary CT scan in other hospital showed significant stenosis at proximal LAD. He doesn't have any history of MI or previous revascularization of coronary artery. Next. And he has several risk factors that are diabetes, hypertension, and he is a current smoker. So his clinical presentation is stable angina. Next. This is a baseline ECG of this patient. If you look at this ECG, there are some T-wave inversion in V4, 5, 6, and AVL and lead 1. Next. And this is a chest PA. There's no definite cardiomegaly. And we also perform echocardiography. It shows normal AV systolic function and no regional wall motion abnormalities. This is a baseline coronary angiography. In this right coronary angiogram, there's a mild stenotic region at proximal RCA. And right, this is a PA caudal view. You can see some mild stenotic region at left circumflex artery. Moving next. Yes, moving on to further projection. You can see diffuse stenotic region from proximal LAD to mid LAD, and there's a quite tight lesion at diagonal branch. And right, this is a spider view. You also can find stenotic lesion at proximal to mid LAD and RI branch.
So let me summarize the patient. 62-year-old male patient with a stable angina and performed CT at the hospital and showed severe stenosis at the proximal LAD. And he had a history of diabetes, hypertension, and smoker. And we performed the coronary angiography, and RCA showed intermediate lesion, mild to intermediate, and FFR was negative 0.85. And the problem is the left side. Can you please show the today's coronary angiogram? Yeah, this is spider view. Can you please show the cranial view?
Cranial view?
Yeah. This is cranial view. And prox-LAD shows the severe diffuse intermediate stenosis. And we checked the FFR, and the result was 0.74. The functionally significant LAD stenosis with very tight diagonal stenosis with a TME2 flow. And also he had a typical chest pain, and we decided to perform PCI for LAD and diagonal region and defer the RCA. And when planning the LAD PCI, the problem is the diagonal branch. The patient has only one big, large diagonal branch, and we cannot find other diagonal branch except for the very distal diagonal branch. So this diagonal branch would be functionally very significant with a larger territory of the myocardium, supra myocardium. So I decided to perform to protect the diagonal branch with the upfront 2 stent. And because I'm familiar with the crush stent, so crush stent technique, so I will perform the mini crush with the mini crush technique with the side branch optimization. I will show you that our routine practice. And for today's procedure, I prepared the radial 7 branch to gain the large lumen. And he is now not admitted in hospital. He is receiving the PCI in the same day clinic. After the procedure, he will be discharged today afternoon. And as you can see in the angiography, I use the Jokin left 7 French with outside hole. And I prepare the OCT for intravascular imaging. For the complex bifurcation procedure, the role of intravascular imaging is crucial. And for this patient, the OCT will be used. And I did some wiring. Can you please show the angiography? After the LAD wiring with the Sion wire and diagonal branch wiring with the BMW wire, I just performed the 2.0 compliant small balloons. Next, for flow recovery. There was some flow limitation after diagonal branch wiring. Next. And then we check the OCT. And can you please show the OCT result? Yes, this is the OCT pullback. Can you please play the pullback? Yeah. Routinely, we check the OCT with the 75 millimeter pullback for the longer length coverage and fast pullback. And for this case, I use the hand injection and with about the usual of the contrast about 7 to 8 cc per pullback. And you can see in the LED pullback, then the vessel and lumen is clearly visualized, and you can see the balloon related to some dissection. And here, prox LED, there are still disease, and the vessel is widening to left main. So we measured that the edge, you can see the image is well co-registered with the angiography, so I can easily check the landing zone. Just distal to the septal branch, there's good distal landing zone. Can you please show the distal landing zone? Yeah. You can see there's no plug and very clear vessel in just distal to the septal branch. And the size was about 3.25 in the vessel area. And can you please move forward? And here was the tightest region. And because I already performed the 2.0 balloon, there's some balloon-related dissection. And proximally move. And diagonal branch comes in the 2 o'clock. And next. And there's some diffuse intimate stenosis. And here, the ostium of the LAD would be the landing zone of the stent. So with this result, we measured the total length of the region, and it was 28. And distal landing zone vessel size was 3.25. So, yes, 3.25. So I decided to put the 3.25 by 28 millimeter stent, and then perform the aggressive post dilation with larger balloon size to approach the proximal side. And next, can you please show the diagonal pullback? And after 2.0 compliant ballooning to open the diagonal branch, we perform the OCT pullback from diagonal branch. And as you can see, the diagonal branch has a severe stenosis. And just ostium is not so diseased, but still there's a diffuse stenosis and very large diagonal branch. So I want to protect the diagonal branch. So upfront two stent is planned with this image. And as you can see, the vessel size is about 2.75. And at the just proximal opening is here, you can see that the diffuse stenosis, diffuse plaque at the diagonal branch ostium. The region length of the diagonal branch was 21, so I chose 2.75 by 23 millimeter stent. So I begin the procedure from all of these images and information. And the procedure itself would be very straightforward with predefined stent and balloon sizes. And can you please give me the balloon? This is 3.5 NC balloon for predilation of the LAD branch, LAD region, and crushing of the diagonal branch. And put the LAD balloon here. And this is 2.75 by 23 millimeter stent. This is a giant stent. Okay. 7 French radial sheath is useful for bifurcation stenting. Usually with the 6 French, it's very hard to use the larger size balloons and stents. And we must check the several views not to miss the ostium. Oh, it's not so good. Okay. Test. Okay. Test again. Okay, this is the landing of the diagonal branch. Stent. It's good. Test again. Okay, good. I will try to the minimal mini crush. Someone calls it nano crush. I will try. Okay, nominal? Just 10 ATM.
10?
To 2.7. Deflation. Then, oh no, not yet. Okay, 12.
12 nominal.
Okay.
It looks that stent is well expanded, deflation. But further step is our routine to for the best result of the two stenting, and that is the side branch optimization after stenting with the larger NC balloon. To maximize the opening of the side branch stent, facilitate the easy rewiring after crushing and well opening with the side branch ballooning and kissing. So this is the very important step for successful two stenting with a crush, classical crush. Okay, nominal, this is 2.75 NC.
12.
14. There was severe calcification here. Deflation. And as measured before, the austere side of the diagonal branch was about 3.0. So I can apply the very high pressure. 20.
20.
24. Deflation. Okay.
Test.
Okay. Okay. Diagonal branch flow is good, so I will remove all diagonal branch wire and balloon together. Okay, and then 6, 8. Okay, this is deflation. Stand flat down. 10.
10.
14.
14.
This is pre dilation and crushing of the side branch deflation. You can see that the side branch stent is crushed. Okay. And then I will put the predefined size and length of the stent by 3.25 by 28. This is giant stent. Test, please. You should check the distal landing zone. Okay, it's clear without dissection. Test. Okay, distal landing zone is good. And I wanna put the stent at the just ostium of the LAD. Let's see. Test. Okay, test. Okay, it looks good. Okay, nominal.
12.
12.
Mm. inflation. After pulling the stent and the NC balloon for the optimization of the proximal stent is the key of the successful procedure. I will use 3.5 NC that I have used before. And edge measured on OCT. Can you please show the OCT? What is the size of the proximal LAD vessel, especially in the diagonal branch bifurcation and LAD osteo? Nominal. 3.5, 12. Inflation. OCT shows that the proximal LAD just distal to the diagonal branch is about 3.5, 10, 12, 14.
14.
Deflation. And after the diagonal branch, the proximal to diagonal branch, the vessel size is very large, 20. 24.
24.
Deflation. So this high pressure inflation optimized the proximal stent and the works like a pot at the side of the wrench. And let's rewire to side branch. I will reuse the BMW wire that I have used before. BMW is there. My condition is not so good, but I will try once. Okay. With these steps, with the post side branch maximization, without double kissing, we could achieve the good angiographic and intercore imaging result and easily wiring. Okay. Here there's some resistance. But the rewiring is not so difficult with just BMW wire. And anchor go, yeah. For the anchoring at the LAD branch, I will use 3.5 again. And we'll open the side branch ostium with a 2.0 compliant that I have used for the first predilation. 2.0 compliant.
2.0.
네. And some study shows that with the OCT evaluation for the checking the position of the rewiring, but I'm not routinely using the OCT for rewiring the position check in routine clinical practice. Okay. This is 2.0 compliant that I have used before. Easy to close, and we'll use the anchor. 3.56. Okay. Deflation. Okay, with the anchoring, 2.0 compliant relay balloon easily passed the side branch ostium. And I believe that because I did the side branch maximization before the crushing, that helped the easily cross. 2.0.
16.
18. 18. Deflation. This is compliant balloon, but still works very well even in the 18.
18.
Yeah. Deflation. Okay. And 2.75 NC, please. This is 2.75 that I have used for the side branch optimization. Okay. It easily passes, even though this is NC balloon. 2.75, 20.
20.
Well expanded. Depression. 24. Good.
24?
Yeah, the side chart shows that 24 is about 3.0. Depression. And 3.5, 16,
18.
The lumen gain is achieved by the alternative NC ballooning. And the final kissing balloon just helped to optimize the position of the carina. So we do not need high pressure for the kissing balloon. The position of the balloon. Position is good. Okay,
8, 8, 4, 6, 8.
Yeah, this is final step. And the balloon, the kissing balloon looks beautiful. Deflation. Okay. And the good core work and team cooperation is very important for the successful and fluent procedure. Okay, let's check the angio. Okay, the result is good. And I will check the final OCT for check the result of the stent. The optimization of the acute stent result makes a good long-term clinical outcomes. And the role of intravascular imaging is to optimize the acute stent result. With the intravascular imaging, we can use the appropriate size of the stent and balloon with a larger size and a higher pressure with safety. And also, after the procedure, we check the stent opposition and expansion, and also the edge, check the edge problem, and it can minimize the acute stent-related problems and make better long-term clinical outcome. Yes. Yes, this is the step, and I will push the pullback button. Okay. Thank you. Okay. There's some stenosis distal to the diagonal branch, but I will just leave it alone. And you can clearly see the side branch stent. Can you please show it again from the beginning? Okay, the dot, white dot means the stent. And can you please show from the distal? Yeah. Here, this is the distal edge of the stent. And we cannot find any dissection or hematoma or other problems. And stent is well opposed at the distal edge. And can you please move forward? Okay, the stent area is more than 4, even though this is the diagonal branch. And here, the 5, more than 5. Stop. And the OCT shows automatically measure the lumen area and the expansion rate. And at the second paragraph, and you can see the area nomogram. And we can see that the stent area is well being larger than from distal to proximal. And can you please move forward? Let's see the bifurcation. Here is the ostium of the bifurcation. And we can see that the side branch side is well covered with the stent strut, and the carina is very short without significant, we cannot find the significant carina, and all vessel was well covered with a stent strut. And can you please move proximally? Okay, I will check the LAD probe for the final result. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And Joe. Okay. The pushing the guiding catheter is very important for stable imaging. And you can see the distal edge is clear without any edge-related problems, and stent opposition and expansion is good. Here the diagonal branch ostium we could see. Can you please review from the distal, the proximal? Here distal stent edge is clear, and stent is well opposed at the distal edge. And the lumen area is more than 6, here more than 7, and more than 8. It becomes larger. And here, the diagonal bifurcation, you can see that there's no carina, and the diagonal ostium is very well opened. And let's move forward. At the very proximal edge, let's see, there's some... It just looks that the stent edge is not opposed, but I think that because the stent is protruded to the polygonal confluence to the left main, so we cannot oppose that. And the stent is well expanded, more than 3 point. Can you please show the proximal stent size? Here, some. 네, 좀 더 뒤로 들어가야겠는데. 네, 좀 더 밑에. 거기 stent size. Here is the ostium of the LAD and very well expanded, more than 4.0 because I performed the kissing balloon at the proximal edge. So the angiography result was good, and the OCT showed there's no edge-related problems, and proximal and distal stent is well opposed, and the stent expansion is excellent. So I will finish the procedure. Can you please inject some nitro? And the patient is very stable, vital sign is good, and after the procedure, if the patient is stable, he will be discharged today afternoon. Okay. With the guidance of the intravascular imaging, even after bifurcation stenting and left main stenting is very stable, and then the patient is discharged same day with safety. And final angio. Angio. Okay, good. I'll check the caudal view. Let's see. Angio. Okay. The stent is well placed at the ostium of the LAD, and the circumflex and RI branch is not damaged. And finally, let's check the distal vessels to exclude the wire-related injury. Okay. It looks good. Okay, I will finish the procedure. And let me summarize my case. The patient, 62-year-old with stable angina and severe LAD and diagonal disease. And we planned upfront 2 stent because there was only one large diagonal branch and severely diseased. This is a significant diagonal branch disease. So with upfront 2 stent, under the guidance of the OCT, and we could perform the procedure very safely and safely with the most effectiveness, and I will finish the procedure. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for your attention. Thank you. 수고하셨어요.
Okay, thank you for joining the TCTAP 2022 virtual meeting, and we will prepare one of interesting the significant LED ostium and distal lamin the case, and I will introduce our team. I'm the DW Park from Assam Medical Center, and first assistant in the Jin Ho the Lee, and the second assistant is Jin Sun Park. Okay, Jin Ho, can you introduce a patient background?
Yeah, I'm Jin Ho Lee from Assam Medical Center. Let me show the brief summary of this case. The 76-year-old male patient was admitted for upper chest pain, and we performed coronary angiography and showed the significant stenosis at the distal left main and LAD ostium and distal subcomplex and OM branch. And we planned the revascularization of this lesion. And he had no coronary artery disease in the past medical history. Next. He had two risk factors, which is hypertension and hypolipidemia. And the clinical presentation of this patient was stable angina. Next. The electrocardiogram show basically normal sinus rhythm and borderline left ventricle hypertrophy and no definite ST change. Next. In chest radiograph, there is no evidence of cardiomegaly or pulmonary edema. Next. And we performed echocardiography that showed the normal LV function. And let's see the coronary angiogram in this patient.
Okay, this patient 67 and the male presented the stable angina. Okay, could you, this is, today we're gonna check the angio and the could you show us the first angio RCA? So, and looking at the RCA, we can see the intermediate stenosis, the prox RCA region 50 and 60%, and extend to the, from the prox RCA to mid RCA part. So, and our usual practice, we used for intermediate region, we use FFR as default treatment decision making. So for this RCA region, we checked the FFR. FFR today, could you show us FFR, the figure? This is 0.93, and using the intravenous adenosine and the hyperemic status, FFR value was 0.93. So, and we decide to the medical or just OMT for RCA coronary region. Today, the target region is SUC region. Could you show us the epicoronary view? So, and this is epicoronary view. We can see, and the true SUC branch is not big. And we can see, however, there is significant stenosis, the big OM branch, and the distal part of the big OM branch, there was a significant stenosis. So we're going to do evaluation of IVUS. Also, we can see the distal lamin and added ostium was a very tight stenosis. And next one. So this is a spider view, and by angiography, SUC ostium is relatively okay, and just 30%. LAD ostium looks very tight. We will check the IVUS again. And next view, the we can see the very the diffuse disease from distal lamin to the mid LAD part, and also there was some big diagonal branch, and just with the keep the wire. So, and our first step and the RCA was decide to the OMT on the basis of the FFR. So, and we will check the IVUS and the treatment of the OM and the LAD branch. Okay? So, and the IVUS. Okay, the Gino, and this patient has a risk factor, no diabetics.
Yeah.
And just hypertension and hyperlipidemia.
Yes.
Okay. So, and IVUS, and this is HD IVUS by the Boston Scientific. This is, our center is one of the largest center, most commonly used IVUS in the world. So, and the nearly 100% case that we used IVUS for stent optimization. So, and the Assam Medical Center practice, if I'm gonna summarize two strategy part and one part, the gatekeeper for decision-making, treat or not treat, we use FFR. If you decide to the treatment PCI, And the stent optimization, we depending on the IBUS and the 100%. That was our Asan Medical Center routine, the strategy for treatment of the significant coronary artery disease. Okay. Could you show us the IBUS? So, and this is the IBUS view and the distal part. And we can see over here and the OM branch. And here is relatively okay. The, we will guess that this part might be the distal landing zone, 3-4 in general, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. 아까 그 나오기 전부터 네. 3-4 in general. There was some luminal narrowing and the plaque burden would be 40 and 50% over here. That was a narrowest part, and you can see the encircling plaque, the huge plaque, lumen area less than 1.0 approximately. So we will treat over there. And then the, we're gonna show us the proximal part. Could you caudal repeat? Okay. Caudal view. Yeah. Okay, here. And here, and this is the proximal, but just the proximal of the bifurcation. Here is the proximal part over here. There is a plaque rupture. We can see the plaque rupture and 4 o'clock. Okay, here is the huge plaque. And the huge plaque over here, we gonna plan to cover up to this part. Okay, here. Mm-hmm. Okay, this part is 3.5. And then upper part, some narrowing. And our another target, this is for RIBUS evaluation was subostium. Is there some disease or not? Is a spider view, there is no significant disease, just a mild disease. Okay, here is ostium. It's widely open, okay?
Yeah.
So plaque is just 30%. Okay, here is ostium. Okay, good.
Yeah.
I think by IBUS lumen is okay. So, okay, our part, could you show us the most narrowest part of the sock? This is the lumen diameter, is 3.0, and distal most narrowest over here. Could you measure the lumen area? So, okay, great. Lumen area is just 1.7, and we are decide to put the stent. Also, could you show us the plaque rupture area, some plaque circle part over here, and we can see the some plaque rupture over here, and we will treat over there. Okay, and could you measure the overall length? Forty-four is just the longest synergy stent is 38, right?
Yeah.
So we are put the two stent, distal part is 3.0, proximal part is 3.5. 48도 있어?
네.
그럼 48로 하자.
네.
3.0. Okay, 3.0, 48. 안 되면 염려 전혀 하지 마세요. 잘 되고 있어. 3.0 on the basis of the IBUS, so we decide 48, and the longest one, the synergy stent, is 48. So, and we can treat with just one stent. And the most popular drug-eluting stent in ASEAN, also in Korea, and the Giants, and Resolute, and Synergy, and Ultimate, and Design. And I think there is no significant difference in the patient outcome, device outcome, in the contemporary drug-eluting stent. And for that region, there is no severe calcification. I would do a direct implantation for the target region. Okay, the passed well. Okay, test. 오케이. 좀 뒤에 맞춰도 되지? 네. 48이면 좀 앞에까지 가도 되나? 자, 테스트. 이 정도인데, 뒤에는 자, 이 정도. 자, 테스트. 앞에까지 가야 되겠다. 그지? 네, 여기. 자, 고, 가.
누나 11? 6.
6?
6.
6.
2.9.
아, 6. 오케이. 7.
7.
8. 오케이. 디플릿. Some, the narrowed part is not fully dilated. Okay, one more implant. 6, 8, 10.
10.
Okay, good. Okay, save. Deplete. 자, NC를 그럼 두 개 써야 되겠다. 네. Distal part 3.0 and our the Assam Medical Center routine is use the post dilation using non-compliant balloon. Okay. 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 This is the 3.0. Okay. NC balloon. Okay. 3.0 맞죠?
3.0입니다.
루미날 12입니다.
Okay, over here, we will use the stem booster. Over here, 자, 고! 루미날.
12.
12, 14.
14.
Okay. Okay, expand it well. Deplete.
Deplation.
자, 12, 14.
14.
14. 16.
16.
오케이, 세이브. 디플릿. 자, 14, 16.
18. 18.
세이브. 디플릿. 3.5. And then we will apply the 3.5.
짧은 걸로 될까요?
15, 15. 네. And the proximal part, we will apply the 3.5, 15, and the NC balloon. Okay. This is NC balloon. Okay. 자, 고. 12.
12.
12. 14.
14.
Save. Deplete. 자, 14. 16.
16.
18.
18.
Save. Deplete. Okay. 잠깐만. Booster. Okay, good. 20.
20.
20.
Okay, save. Deplete. Okay, and then we're gonna give some a bit of nitro and then check the angio and IVUS again. 네이트 한번 주세요. Good. Okay. 자, 이렇게 한번 찍어볼까요? 천천히.
Ready?
Okay. Good shot. Okay. Angiographically looks fine. And we will check the IVUS. Okay. Great. So that was our routine step for PCI and the pre-evaluation of the IVUS and post-evaluation IVUS. In the IVUS optimization criteria on the basis of IVUS, we're gonna between the less diameter with the EEM and the more diameter than the lumen area. Okay, over here, go. And the IVUS, we will check it up. There is some major the PCI complication like some severe dissection or something like that. and the distal part, and okay, here. Here is a transition zone. There is a well opposed, there is no major complication like dissection. Okay, and expanded well, great. Great. Okay, good, expanded well. Yeah. 아버님 한쪽은 잘 됐고 나머지 한쪽 이제 한 뭐 10분, 20분이면 끝납니다. Yeah. 예. Okay, here is expanded well. Excellent. It's a very concentric, the, you know, expansion well. And, okay, great. Good. Here is the proximal part of edge. Good. Mm. Expanded well, there is no inner position, and fully expanded. If you're going to use the IBUS, you can decide and the proper size of the stent also, and immediate optimization. Stent optimization, IBUS role, is I think it's the biggest, you know, contemporary the tool. So I'll move to the LAD and the left main part. So here is I put the sock wire, and then I put the additional wire for diagonal branch and the shion blue. Yeah. One more. Mm. Okay, no cool. This is sock. On the sock, huh?
Shion blue.
Okay, this diagonal branch is not small. Okay, 자 epicranial view. Okay. Okay, diagonal branch is not small, but just I just do and keep the wire. So and nowadays one of the booming technology of the balloon, you know, the protection technique. Okay. Okay, here tester. This is a shion blue wire, just keep the wire. And here, and I will check the IBUS. And so, and looking at the epicranial view, I'm gonna show you again. Okay. 요거는 저기, 다이구나 브랜치. 네. 이렇게 한번 이렇게 해놨어.
예.
자, 이렇게 해놓고. So, and looking at the one zoom epicranial view, region is very extended to the distal part. So, and I will check the whole the segment of the LAD part and then decide the whole length of the stent. 야, 미드까지 해야 될 수도 있겠다, 그래?
네.
It's a, you know, diffuse long region. And the poor distal left main part is on the basis of the IBUS, and the circle ostium is just a mild stenotic, the region lumen is okay, so I decide to just stand crossover. 자, 미드까지 쭉 들어가 볼게. 오케이, 한 요 정도까지. 그럼 요 미드까지 다 들어갔지? 네. 자, 테스트 한번 살짝 해볼까? 여기 미드까지 다 들어갔나?
네, 테스트 했습니다.
그지? 오케이, 고! 네. 오해. 오케이, here is a distal part of LAD and 3.0 epicranial view만 보여주면 돼. Here is the 아직 나왔나? 잠깐만. Not yet. Not yet. So the mid LED test portion will coming over here. Oh, here. 와, 이거 타이트하다, 그지?
네.
해야 되겠다, 이거 아래까지. 3.0. And we will measure the lumen area. Here is a 3.0. And just upper part of the mid LED, the narrowest portion. 깊게 두 개 해야 될 수 있겠어. 3.0, here part is 1, 2, 3, 3.0. Okay. This is a diffuser plug. Here is the diffuser plug. Septal is coming. Here is the proximal narrowest part. Here is 3.5. And the diffuse disease. Okay, the diagonal branch is coming. The 3 o'clock. Okay, we just put the wire. Okay. Okay, here. Good. Very tight. Wow. 3.5. There is some rupture about 12 o'clock. Okay, here is also is diffuse disease. Wow. And the, another the
branch.
Branch. Here is the LED ostium, nearly 4.0, lumen size 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, more than 4.5. It's not the lemon yet. LED ostium over here. Wow, very tight. Encircling.
Okay.
Wow. It's very severe disease. So I'm gonna targeting over here the sharp part of the lemon ostium. Okay. It's a Chani Kuju, the major lumen area, the mid LED tightest part. So we decide to overall the region length over here. 여기구나. 아우, 잘로 가네. Over here. Lumen is just 2.3. Wow. And if you decide full cover the distal part to the lemmain, and what is the overall length?
Uh, 74.
그러면은 38이면
76.
어, 그 정도면 되겠네, 그지? The 38, 뭐가 44가 있나?
48 이렇게
그래요? 그럼 38, 3.0, 38?
네. 네,
first. 오케이, 줘보세요. 그럼 되겠다. 오케이, 3.0, 38, first. Okay, this is 3.0. Proximal part, we're gonna put the in the severe calcified region, we usually do predilation, but not the severe calcified region, just mild calcified region, we just do the direct stenting over there. Okay, this is a 38 for mid LED part. 자, 여기서 테스트 한번 보여주고.
테스트.
자, 아래까지인데, 그지? 자, 여기서 한번 찍고 들어갈게요. 레디? 자, 풀샷. 저 아래까지네. 저기만 딱 커버하면 되네. 요거 하나 올려주세요. 힐. 그렇지. 아, 오케이, 굿. 저 아래까지. 자, 여기까지 다 테스트. 조금 나와야지.
네.
자, 테스트. 여기면은 딱 셉탈 있는 데인데, 그지?
네.
저 셉탈 맞추면 되겠다, 그지?
네.
자, 테스트. 자, 여기서 고.
노미널 11.
노미널 10.
10.
아,
오케이. 10. 오케이, expanded well. 오케이, deplete. Additional 3.5, 38. A시면 되겠지?
네.
어, 오케이. 굿. 3.5. 오케이. 근데 overlap site just distal part of the diagonal branch. The not much concern of a two stand overlap in the diagonal all still. Okay. Left main shaft is big and we just approximately overlap the stand edge to edge would be on the basis of IBUS and the stand length would be okay. 살짝 이렇게 놓고 자 오버랩 된다만 볼게요. 부스터 is good for 네. overlap. 오케이 okay. 테스트. 자 여기 살짝 크레니얼. 자 테스트. 하하 잠깐만 조금 모질라는 것 같기도 하고 그럼 하나 더 넣어도 되겠지. 아이고 모질라다. 자 테스트.
테스트. 어 잠시만요.
어, 천천히 천천히.
다이 채우겠습니다.
그럼 3.5 좀 짧은 거하고 4.0 해야 되니까 오케이. 테스트. 모질라다. 그지?
네.
두 개로.
긴 거. 어, 48. 어, 어, 제일 긴 거. 그럼 되겠다. 3.5. 굿. 보세요. 또 시너지 48, 3.5. 오케이, this is 3.5. 오케이, good. 오케이, gently insert. 오케이. 오케이. This is additional 48. 자, 여기서 좀 오버랩 돼도 상관없어. 테스트. 오케이. 충분하네. 앞에만 맞추면 되겠다. 뒤에는 오버랩 돼도. 자, 테스트. 조금 더 들어갈게요. 자, 테스트. So, I think Lumen is okay. So, shallow LAO. 자, 테스트. 자, 고.
11, 12.
오케이. Deplete. And we will apply the 3.0 NC. 자, 오케이. 자, 주세요. 메인을 붙이려면 3.5, 오케이? Or more peak size balloon? 4.5, 오케이. This is a 3.0 NC balloon to optimize the distal part. Okay, over here. 자. 오케이, this is 3.0 NC balloon over here. 오케이, over here.
오늘 철근입니다.
잠깐만. 자, 고! 넘나?
12.
오케이. 자, 세이브. 디플릿. 자, 12. 14.
14.
오케이, 세이브. 디플릿. 16. 오케이, 세이브. 디플릿. 자,
16.
18, 20. Okay, save. Deplete. 자, 20,
20.
Okay, save. Deplete. 3.5. 자, 고. 3.5. This is 3.5. 잠깐만, 네. 아직 안 들어 안 나왔지?
네.
자, 위에 보여주고. This is a used one. 잠깐만. 한번 써서 이게 안 들어간다. 자, 그러면 와이어를 오케이. 미드 팟. 다이고날 브랜치가 어떤 거였지?
요거지? 네.
자, 테스트.
테스트.
잠깐만, 이게 안 들어갔다. 좀 빼서. 자, 테스트.
테스트.
다이고날 괜찮아 보인다, 그지?
네.
자, 요 와이어를. 그러면 서클을 뺄게. 요게 서클다, 그지?
네.
원 와이어 리무브. 안 들어가네. 잠깐만. 그러면 here is a used NC balloon and this is LED and there would be some wire kinking and renegotiate wire again over here. 자, 이렇게 해서 할죠. Here is a rewire.
토크
있지?
네.
잠깐만. 이렇게 놓고 자, 코달 가봐. 여기 코달. 오케이, I'm gonna try to recross the wire over here. 오케이, 잠깐만 조금 더 다치고 들어갔어. 오케이, 괜히야?
알겠습니다.
오케이, 됐지? 여기 LED지?
예.
And that I tried we cross again. 이거 한번 써서 이거 안 들어갔다. 그렇지? 그러면은 그럼 new one 하나 줘보실래? 네. 3.5. new one. 밑으로 들어가실 수도 있겠다. 그러면 와이를 새로 좀 넣어볼게. 이렇게 놓고 잠깐 다시. 다시 에피코달. 그러면 와이를 좀 새로 넣지. 이게 밑으로 들어갔을 수도 있어. 오케이. 자, 토크 달고 오케이. 자, 시스템 써보시오. 오케이, 그
토크 있습니다.
됐다. 자, 한번 와이어 그 볼륨 좀 새로 줘봐.
네.
3.5 new one?
네, new one입니다.
오케이. 'Always be careful. There is some possibility of interposition of the proximal part. Okay. 잠깐만. 됐다, 됐다.
크레니아.
크레니아. Okay, over here. 자, 고. 12.
12.
14, 16.
16.
18.
18.
세이브. 디플릿. 자, 20, 20.
23.7.
20.
오케이, 세이브. 디플릿. 자, 20.
23.7.
20.
오케이, 세이브. 디플릿. 자, 20.
23.7. 20.
Okay, save. Deplete. Booster. Okay, 20.
20.
22.
22.
24.
24.
Deplete. 자, okay, 20. 22.
22.
24.
24.
Okay, deplete. 그리고 위에는 얼마로 해야 되지?
메인은 루멘이 커서 4.5 해야 돼.
4.5, 4.5. 네. 자, 테스트 한번 살짝 해봐. 테스트.
테스트.
오케이, 다이고널 괜찮다, 그지? 이거 뺄게. 오케이, I'm removed. And 4.4 in 5, 네, left main. 오케이. 메인은 컸죠? 좀 나왔네, 그지? 잠깐만 여기서 자, 고!
네?
16, 18
18?
4.75?
이 정도만 가면 되나?
네,
디플릿? 자, 오케이, 조금 나와서 자, 고! 20
18,
4.75? 20
20
오케이, 세이브, 디플릿. 자, 이제 레디. 자, 빼오죠. 자, 입니다. 이제 자, 풀샷. 굿. I think the region is expanded well. Okay, right here. Good. Main is good. Sock Austin is good. Epicranial. Digital LED is excellent. So, I'm gonna check the final algos. Diagonal branch is good. So, and our overall treatment strategy is very straightforward. And the reason why we select the bigger balloon is we already know the overall the region morphology on the basis of the iBoost. That is the key factor we decide to the large balloon, 4.5, something like that. Okay. Here is a distal landing. Okay, good. Good, excellent. Distal landing part is excellent, and there is no dissection at all. And the pool expanded. Expanded well. Oh, it's 1, 2, 네 개 들어갔구나. 네. Yeah. It's 38, 48. Total three, the long synergy stent was implanted well. Good. Here is expanded well, and here we are full dilated using 3.5. Good. Here is the added ostium. Good. Expanded well. Here is the sulci ostium. We can see the wide open of the sulci ostium. Here is the left main. Okay, good. It's expanded well. Okay. So, and overall, the treatment decision is very straightforward. Okay, I'm going to... do final angel. Okay, angel.
Ready?
자, full shot. Good. And epicoral view and spiral view. I'm gonna finish. Okay, full shot. It's good. And the spiral view. 자, angel. Full shot. Good. So, I think overall procedure result is excellent. IVUS finding is good. And so I think this patient is a nice representative of how can you decide to IVUS base the PCI in the contemporary practice. So thank you for joining all audience. I really enjoyed all audience and learn and share your knowledge in the this year TCTAP 2022 meeting. And the end of the COVID-19 and the next year, I hope that everyone we met in the in-person TCTAP 2023 meeting. Thank you for joining.